君を救いたい千の涙から。
Something is odd.
Late at night, Tanaka Toshiko is alone in the dining room. Toshiko is lost in her thoughts with a cup of tea in her hand. If someone asked her what exactly is so odd, she wouldn't be able to give a satisfactory answer. But she senses there's something wrong, and she trusts her intuition. Yuri is Yuri, and yet somehow she is not the person she used to be. For the past few days, Toshiko has had this uneasy feeling. She senses some unexplainable changes have come over Yuri. They're little things, but they bother her. For example, after washing her face, Yuri used to toss her towel over the rail by the sink and leave it all crumpled. But yesterday and this morning, it was hung up neatly. When Yuri brushes her teeth, she used to put a cup on her left. But last night, it was on the right. Cleaning up her messy room for a change is understandable, but other little changes are not.
Can simple habits change overnight? But then Yuri is my daughter. There's no doubt about it. Well, maybe it's nothing to worry about.
As she is ready to go to bed, she hears a knock on the front door.
Who is it?
Well, it's Ota Ichilo.
Oh, Ichilo! I haven't seen you for a long time. What can I do for you?
Could I see Yuri, please?
She may be asleep. Shall I wake her up?
No, that's all right. I saw a friend of mine today, and he told me that there seemed to be something odd about Yuri. That worried me. That's why I've come.
Ichilo, I've had the same feeling. Somehow Yuri seems different.
Really?
Yes. But it's nothing serious.
Tell me how she is different.
What's up, Mom?
Yuri, Ichiro's here.
Hi, Ichiro. The party was fun the other day, wasn't it?
Yes, it was. I see you're still awake.
Well, you too. Why don't you come up to my room?
Sure.
He follows her. From the bottom of the stairs, Toshiko looks after them worriedly.
Make yourself at home. What brought you here so late at night?
Yuri lets Ichiro in and sits down on her bed.
Well, do you remember the book I lent you? I'd like it back if you can find it. I need it.
What book? What was it about?
Egyptian history. You said it was interesting.
Oh, yes. Yes, it was. But where did I put it? I'll have to look for it, but not tonight, I'm afraid.
That's okay. I have other books. Sorry to have bothered you so late.
That's all right.
I guess I must be going. See you. Good night.
Good night.
Ichiro leaves her room and goes downstairs. Yuri sits on her bed, motionless.
How was she?
That's not Yuri.
His words make Toshiko gasp.
Does Yuri have a look-alike?
Yes. I once told Yuri about her look-alike. I wasn't joking. Now the look-alike I met at the party is right upstairs.
Ichiro and Toshiko are talking in the kitchen. They are careful not to be heard from upstairs.
But then, where's Yuri? Oh my goodness! What shall I do? I wish my husband was here. To know what she's done to Yuri.
Yes, we've got to find out. I'm sure Yuri is all right.
What if something happens to Yuri? Ishilo, will you come upstairs with me?
Sure.
They leave the kitchen and go upstairs to Yuri's door. Toshika holds her breath.
I'm coming in.
She flings the door open. Cold air rushes out.
The window's open. She's gone. She got away. I can't see her. I should have questioned her when I had the chance.
Look, Ishilo. It's a letter.
Dear Ichiro and Yuri's mother, I knew someday you would find out, but that day came too soon. When Ichiro told me he had lent me a book, I realized that he knew I wasn't Yuri. He would have asked me over the phone if he had only wanted the book. I can't stay in this house anymore. But I don't want to leave this world. Someday I'll...
The letter's not finished. She must have heard us coming and run away.
She must still be around.
Yes, but what on earth has happened to Yuri?
That girl must know.
They rush downstairs, out the front door, and part right and left. They run off in search of the Yuri's lookalike. A little later, after they leave.
Mom?
The real Yuri comes in the house.
Mom?
She struggles to take her shoes off, staggers into the living room, and falls on the sofa. She grimaces. In the other world, she had been caught in the rain and shot at during the escape. The bullet grazed her right arm. It's not a serious wound, but it's bleeding and it aches too. She was exhausted from pushing up the heavy door to get back to this world. But now she's back home. Yuri's so overcome with relief and fatigue that she can hardly move.
Where's Mom?
It's late at night. The feeling of relief makes her sleepy.
Don't sleep. There's one more thing left to do.
Something within her is trying to keep her awake.
One other thing to do. What is it? After a good night's sleep, I'll tell Mom I'm sorry. Though I'm not the one to blame. I didn't do anything wrong.
She suddenly remembers the other girl. Yuri's almost forgotten about her.
What happened to her?
She opens her eyes. She finds her look-alike looking down at her. Could it be a dream? For a second, Yuri is not sure. Then she realizes that the girl is about to attack her by raising a sharp knife in her hand.
Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. No!
Yuri cries out and dodges the blow. She jumps to her feet.
What are you doing? Why did you come back? Wait. You're Julia, aren't you?
Yuri calls her by the name by which she is known in the other world.
How do you know my name? You met my son, didn't you? Ken is worried about you. Please go back. You're his mother, aren't you? It's too late. It's not too late. You can go back through the tunnel. You know Ken is waiting, don't you? I want to stay in this world. Why? Everything is in reverse for you in this world.
Julia gasps. She throws open the sliding door and runs out into the yard.
Here you are. What did you do to Yuri?
Ichiro, it's me. I'm Yuri.
Don't lie to me.
Ouch!
Are you hurt?
I've been shot. Let me go!
Your clothes are different. Are you really Yuri?
Ask me again and I'll punch you.
Okay, you're Yuri, I can tell.
He raises his hands to protect his head.
You were shot?
Ozawa Yoko doesn't seem to believe Yuri's story.
How long have you been a secret agent? Well, you don't have to believe me. I only told you because you wanted me to. But it's just incredible. It's only natural for Yoko not to believe me. Sometimes even I doubt whether it actually happened.
It's been more than 10 days since Julia, the mother, disappeared. Neither Yuri nor Ichiro has seen her. They wonder if she's gone back to her own world.
Somehow, I have a feeling that Julia is still in this world. But I want no part of that story anymore. What I experienced in the other world was most interesting, but I don't want to go back again. If I go there again, I'll be killed.
As they walk home from school, the two girls walk by the bookstore where the tunnel to the other world is hidden.
What's the matter, Yuri? This is the bookstore.
Yuri is astonished to find that construction work has started where the bookstore was.
I read a notice saying that this store was closing. I didn't know. What are they going to do with it? They're knocking it down, perhaps. Excuse me, is this building going to be torn down?
Huh? Oh, yeah. It's gonna be a larger building.
A larger building? You mean the basement will be torn down too?
Yes, it will. They're gonna put shops in the basement.
This building is going to be torn down. That means the entrance to the tunnel will be blocked up. When are you going to start?
Tomorrow. Once we get started, it'll come down quickly.
Thank you. Tomorrow?
After Yuri says goodbye to Yoko, she walks along, thinking about Julia.
If she hasn't gone back to the other world yet, she will never be able to return in the future. I am worried, though I can do nothing about it.
As Yuri is passing in front of a playground near her house, she stops to look at some pebbles on the road. They are joined together to form letters. They read Emmett.
Emmett? So Ken must be around.
Yuri walks into the playground. She finds some children playing. Beside them is an old man sitting in the sun on a bench.
Ken! Are you okay? I've been worried about you.
Are you all right? Didn't you get hurt?
It's not serious. Ken, is Julia back?
No. I came back to look for her, but I haven't found her yet.
That's what I've been worried about. Do you know that they're pulling down the building with the entrance to the tunnel?
I know. There's another problem. Because you're back too, my mother is growing a year older each day.
And she must be... Oh, no!
Yuri is frightened by what this means.
She's nearing the end. In another 3 days, she'll vanish. Each day getting 1 year older means 1 year younger for her. When she is less than 1 year old, she won't even exist.
We must do something. Tonight. She has to go back tonight.
How can we find her? Do you have any ideas?
I'm not sure. But how about this? Will you come with me and watch out for her in front of my house tonight?
Come on. Stop it. It makes me feel weird.
Yuri and Ichiro are out for a walk as a couple.
We're only pretending. Don't you understand? Just do as I tell you.
Okay.
Ichiro and Yuri, walking arm in arm, really look like a couple in love.
Don't stick so close to me. It's hot out here.
In this cold? Stop complaining. You don't know how lucky you are.
Lucky? I think that's enough.
No, it isn't. Shall we kiss?
No! I won't.
Can't you see I'm being nice to you? Act like a man!
But... Look, that little girl.
Yuri turns around and sees a little girl looking at them from behind a lamppost.
Julia!
The girl turns and is about to run. But she stops when she sees Ken appear in front of her.
Thank God! You're just in time, Mother.
Mother?
Let's go home. It's not too late.
The little girl turns back and looks at Ichiro with tears in her eyes.
Ichiro, give her a hug.
What?
Please do it.
All right.
Ichiro goes to the little girl and kneels to hold her in his arms. The girl clings to him and presses her face into his shoulder.
Let's go. Thank you, Yuri.
You're welcome. Take care.
Thank you. Goodbye.
The old man and the little girl, like grandfather and granddaughter, walk away in the darkness of the night. The little girl turns around for the last time and gives Ichiro and Yuri a little nod. Then the two seem to fade away.
She looked so sad.
Yeah. We probably won't see her again. Let's go inside.
Yeah. Look. My shoulder's damp. She was crying.
Making girls cry. You should be ashamed of yourself.
It's gone. Yeah.
The next day after school, as they pass by the site where the bookstore was, they watch as a bulldozer digs a hole there.
What has happened to the tunnel? Was it just blocked up? Or did it vanish?
In the bright sunshine of the day, they can hardly believe that an entrance to the other world used to exist in that rubble.
Have Ken and Julia returned to their world safely?
There is no way to find out. Yuri is happy, though, because she imagines that there may be other tunnels to the other world through which those people might be visiting this world unnoticed.
Yuri, I've been to a beauty salon recently. Oh. Look at my face. Don't I look younger? Don't overdo it, okay? Why? If it makes you look too young, no one will recognize you.
Of course, Yoko only took her words as a joke.
Kimi wo
Something is odd.
Late at night, Tanaka Toshiko is alone in the dining room. Toshiko is lost in her thoughts with a cup of tea in her hand. If someone asked her what exactly is so odd, she wouldn't be able to give a satisfactory answer. But she senses there's something wrong, and she trusts her intuition. Yuri is Yuri, and yet somehow she is not the person she used to be. For the past few days, Toshiko has had this uneasy feeling. She senses some unexplainable changes have come over Yuri. Little things, but they bother her. For example, after washing her face, Yuri used to toss her towel over the rail by the sink and leave it all crumpled. But yesterday and this morning, it was hung up neatly. When Yuri brushes her teeth,